Kevin Kemp was an up-and-coming musician in the L.A. nightclub scene.
I think I was seduced by the lifestyle. I started selling dope and making money. Eventually became my own best customer and started smoking up my product and smoking up my profits. And it was downhill from there.
His drug lifestyle led him to make a terrible decision, to break into a home and rob the man that lived there.
Eventually, we were loaded, and to get more money, we went in the house on him.
Kevin kept watch outside while the others attacked the man inside.
Looking through the window, and there was an altercation in the house. I seen him go down, and we left.
That night, Kevin went back to check on the man they robbed. But when he got there, he found him dead. He called the police but fled the scene. Eventually, police brought him in for questioning.
You know, they asked me what happened, and I don't know, I wasn't there. Your story's not adding up, you need to tell us something. You need to tell us more than you're telling us.
Eventually, Kevin confessed to the murder. Even though he didn't actually kill the man, he felt responsible since he planned the robbery.
I feel like I set him up, I did set him up. And if I had not been for that, nothing ever would have happened, and he'd still be here if it wasn't for me.
Kevin was found guilty of second-degree murder and sentenced 15 to life.
All I heard was life. I didn't hear the 15 part. I'm gonna spend the rest of my life incarcerated. How am I gonna do it?
Kevin's girlfriend, Brenda, was devastated. They had two children, and now she would have to raise them alone.
I didn't think he would ever see the light of day. I was really worried about his survival. And the kids growing up, especially my son, you know, without his dad being here.
When I got sentenced, she come and told me that, you know, if you dedicate your life to me and your son, I will do as much of this time with you as I can.
Brenda and Kevin married in a prison waiting room. But life inside was rough for the first-time offender.
I felt really bad about myself, really, like, worthless, you know.
As he dealt with life behind bars, a stranger visited him, who told him that God could forgive his crime and change his life.
I remember telling him, you know, man, I blew it, you know, it's over. And I was taking the Ten Commandments literally, thou shalt not kill.
Then the man told him about Jesus.
God will forgive you for that. God will forgive you. And he convinced me that God will forgive me for it. You know, could forgive us for anything if we repent and confess it to him. So he led me through the sinner's prayer.
Kevin started going to the chaplain's Bible studies.
Initially, it was to get out the cell and then starting to really come to know God, read my word. And I understood more about salvation, the born-again experience.
Kevin earned a college degree and eventually started helping the chaplain. But as he connected with Christians inside, back home, his family was falling apart.
I had asked myself, you know, who am I? What is it that I want? You know, why am I really doing this? Am I doing this for myself, for the kids, for Kevin? So it just came to that crossing the road. I really love my husband, but I just felt like I couldn't do it anymore.
After 7 years, they divorced, but Kevin refused to let go.
But I always had in the back of my mind I would marry her again after I went through my little pity party, that I would marry her again when I got out.
Kevin served 19 years before he was released on good behavior.
I became a man in there. I became a man of God in prison. If you can really get a grip on God and then really trust him and know that he can change lives, we can make it.
And he kept his promise to Brenda.
We talked and we decided to start dating again. And we decided to start right this time. You know, no romance, no, we're gonna do it God's way. And we did that. We dated for like 6 months before we got married.
Life is beautiful now. We're, you know, back together. We're fellowshipping in the same church.
Kevin has started a gospel group called Redemption. Most of the band members are former inmates.
The music is really secondary. It's about becoming men of God, understanding discipleship. That's what God's been giving me lately, that men need to be discipled.
Despite spending almost half of his life behind bars, Kevin is grateful for a second chance.
He saved my life. I think I went to prison. I got rescued. I didn't get arrested. You know, and Jesus rescued me.